There is a secret that God placed in his prophets. The moment you bypass that and you want to do things your own way, he will pass you by. Before any evil happens, there is a sign in the spirit. Go and prosper. There is no more rejection over your life.
I saw also
unbeatable prophecies
in Jomo Kenyatta International, a plane which overskid the runway and it went beyond. You'll also see
deliverances,
the plane landing on a, this
testimonies. Don't miss every Saturday evening the prophetic moment with Prophet William Ssozi.
I am dedicating
Payo
your entire life
Ubulambo bonna
unto the Father,
Eri Kitaffe,
unto the Holy Spirit,
Eri Omoyo Mutukuvu,
unto the angels,
Eri Bamalaika.
And I say as follows. All those principalities that have been against your progress, all those powers that have been putting you in captivity, that have been keeping you in bondage, that have been making you go through this situation, whatever has been limiting your full potential from being exhibited, it is being broken tonight under the power of Jesus Christ. I want you to dedicate your homes. Dedicate the area where you stay. Dedicate your family.
Family yo.
Dedicate your job. Dedicate everything. Thank you, Father.
Wevali chitangi.
Thank you. Christ.
Mulinya erya Yesu Kristo.
Five times repeat after me.
Emirundi etano damu nangi.
I speak
to any power
contrary to the blood of Jesus. Your time is up.
Wherever
you are, I'm sending fire to you. I'm sending power to you. You are leaving me tonight. You are going away tonight. Victory is mine. Victory is mine. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Someone clap for Jesus. There is a difference tonight. There is a change. Take your seats.
Tuleko wansi.
Tell your neighbor tonight.
Gamba mulirwane kiro kya lero.
There is a change.
Waliwo enjawulo.
There is a difference.
Waliwo enjawulo.
Our life,
obulamu bwaffe,
is gonna be different.
Bugenda kuba bwanjawulo.
Remember me when God remembers you. Hallelujah. Let's put our hands together for Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Jesus Christ,
yes, Christo,
is about to change something in your system.
System
inside of you.
Amen.
There is something being changed in your finances. There is something being changed in your home.
Makago.
Something is being changed. Something is happening.
Amen.
In your job.
Amen.
Something is changing.
Amen.
I'm telling you, your life after tonight, your life will not be the same. There is a certain amount of glory that God is putting on you that you will not find anywhere and but from on you. If someone wants to find that power, they will look for you. They will look for you. There is a certain dimension of glory that God is putting on you. A different dimension of power. There is something different. And it will reflect on you. Turn to your neighbor. Say, my neighbor, I may look simple here, but in heaven I'm very different. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
So tonight, it is going to be special, and it's going to be unique. There's something I want us to look at. Just briefly, I won't go into it so much, because the spirit of prophecy is already upon me. I just want to talk about something. And that is the Christians that we have today. The Christians that we have today. The truth is, the people whom we have today, the Christians whom we have today, you know, there is nothing that brings sorrow to my heart. There's nothing that makes me so sorrowful like seeing a Christian who is supposed to be the one exuding power to the world, but instead they are crippled. That thing pains me from the inside of my heart. Whenever I see a Christian or a child of God, someone who purports to be of God, and I see them as, you know, someone who is supposed to exude the power of God, instead, the world is the one exuding its power on this person. That thing hurts me so much. And just get this. We have a lot of Christians today who have begun a trend of begging Jesus.
Nabatandise omulembe ogw'okusaba Yesu.
Kusabiriza.
Okusabiriza Yesu.
You becoming a begging Christian.
Kati naba mulokole naye nga yasabiriza
busabiriza. Tell your neighbor, begging Christian.
Gamba mulirwana abalokole abasabiriza.
God gave you a unique gift.
Katonda yakuwa ekirabo ekyenjawulo.
And that gift is one. Dominion over everything. Now, the moment you contradict that power that God instilled in you, you become nothing. Listen to this. In the Bible, we are taught that God is at the top of the hierarchy of power. But to get to that top, you pass through Jesus Christ. Now, we have a lot of people. I see them all the time. They send me messages, they send me emails. Now, someone sent me a message.
Why do we send kilo obubaka?
Just recently, I said, Prophet, I've looked everywhere.
Nangamba prophet nonyeza buli wamu.
I can't seem to find a job.
Sidaba mulimu.
I can't find a job. I've looked everywhere. I can't find a job.
Sidaba mulimu nonyeza buli wamu. Sidaba mulimu.
Listen to this.
Uliza chini.
You can't find a job.
Tosobola kulaba kufuna mulimu.
But can the job find you?
Naye ate omulimu gwo gusobola okunoonya.
You're looking at it from one perspective. I cannot find a job. I've tried to look for a job.
Gwe okirabiramu side emu nti omulimu gumbuze. Naye ate gwo gusobola okunoonya.
Have you ever asked whether this job you want can find you the same way you want it?
Wali webuzizaako nti guno omulimu gwe njagala gwo gusobola okunoonya engeri gye ngunoonyaamu.
This marriage that you want, can it locate you the way you also want it?
Obufumbo buno bw'oyagala bwo busobola okunoonya mu ngeri emu gy'obunoonyaamu.
You want a house, but does the house also want you as bad as you want it?
Oyagala ennyumba naye n'ennyumba naye kwetaaga bubi nnyo nga bw'ogyetaaga.
The money.
Sente.
You want it, you're praying for it. But can it, does it want you as much as you want it?
Sente?
No, that is the issue. We are looking at things from one side. So you find that we have a lot of people here making false prayers. In other words, you begin to beg. Because a conversation with God is what we call prayer. Prayer is a conversation with God. Now, the begging Christians whom we have, their conversation with God is one-sided. It's always about, hear me, Lord, this. Because you see, when someone is begging you, the beggar is the one who does all the talking and the yapping.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But the one who is with the power to give is just there saying, should I give?
Gamba muwe?
Should I not?
Wasimuwa.
And that is exactly the point I'm driving to.
Kati ensonga jembaleetako.
Listen.
Ulira.
They are what we call empty prayers.
Waliyo esala ze tuyita
ezitaliimu. You're praying a prayer that is empty. It does not carry any substance. It does not change anything. Last week I told you about how words from power can change situations.
Gusabe sala etaliimu teina kyesobola kukyusa. Wiike wedde nabasomesa engeri esala gyekyusaamu embeera.
And it goes and changes. You speak a word and it goes and organizes something.
Yogera ekigambo ne kigenda ne kibaako bye kikyusa.
Just listen to this.
Kati uliriza kino.
There comes a time in a man's life.
Wajjawo akaseera mu bulamu bw'omuntu.
When indeed you have done it all.
Nga mazima byonna obikoze.
And you say you've looked for the job.
N'ogamba emirimu ginoonyeza.
You've woken up so early.
N'engolokoka kumakya.
You've done whatever it takes to see that you get yourself from point A to point B.
Na buli ekyetaagisa okuva ku eno embeera okutuuka ku eri eddaala nkikoze.
You've done it all.
Byonna mbikoze.
But now the issue comes in.
Ne kati ensonga w'ejjira.
You've done it all in flesh.
Byonna obikoze mu mubiri.
What about spirit?
Naye ate mu mwoyo obikoze.
I have done it all. I have woken up early in the morning. I've gone with my box file of applications. I've gone here. I've asked this one.
Byonna mbikoze. Tadde empapula zange ne nsaba omulimu ne mbako ne benkubira.
If only you were that busy in spirit.
Singa bw'otyo bwe wali okola ne mu mwoyo.
You would be far.
Wali badde wala.
So we have a lot of people today kneeling down.
Tuina abantu bangi.
And what they are doing is not praying, but they are begging.
Nenga kye bakola si kusaba naye kusabiriza.
You are begging.
Osabiriza.
That is why God is not listening to you, because you are a beggar.
Chovola Katonda takuuliza kubanga gwe oli musabiriza.
Someone is asking himself,
kati waliwo eyeebuuza.
What does he mean?
Ategeeza ki?
God told us that he who asks in my name will be given.
Katonda yatugamba oyo asaba mu linnya lyange ajja kuweebwa.
He said he who asks, not he who begs.
Yagamba oyo asaba si oyo asabiriza mu linnya lyange.
You see, there is such a thing as covenant.
Kati waliwo ekintu kye tuyita endagaano.
Everything that you see in this world revolves around covenant.
Bulicholaba munse no cheturulira ku ndagaano.
And that is what separates the rich people.
Ericho chechaula abantu abagagga.
From the poor.
Ne kubavu.
The successful.
Aba abagagga. Abakotodde.
Abaisemu.
Abaisemu.
And the unsuccessful.
Naba balemereddwa.
The good.
Abalungi.
And the bad.
Nababi.
God put it there in such a way.
Katonda yakisaawo mu ngeri nti.
If you fail to keep the covenant.
Bw'olemererwa okutuukiriza endagaano.
It is a thin line between good and bad. Good and bad.
Se kati w'ekirungi n'ekibi.
Good and bad.
Ekirungi n'ekibi.
In the Bible.
Mu Bible.
There is a blind man.
Waliwo omusajja muzibe.
When Jesus was walking past,
yes, we are here.
He knelt down and he asked God, he begged God, Lord God, heal me. I'm blind. Jesus healed him and said, go, your faith has healed you. What else did he do in the Bible?
Did
you see him anywhere else? Did he write anything in the Bible? If you beg God,
bosabiriza Mukama,
he will give you something and leave it for you.
Ajja kubako kyakuwa kuleke.
Because he's generous after all, isn't he?
Kubanga ye mugabi.
He's generous.
Mugabi. Amen.
When you beg him, he will give you.
Bomusabiriza ajja kuwa.
Go to the book of 1 Kings.
Tugende mu basekabaka ekisooka.
Verse 19.
19 esula.
Verse 10.
Olunyiriri lwa 10. Basekabaka ekisooka esula 19 olunyiriri lwa 10.
It says,
Wagamba.
1 Kings verse 19 verse 10.
Basekabaka ekisooka 19 10.
This is about the prophet Elijah.
Chekusa kunabi Elijah.
I want you to see how he used to talk to God,
njagala mulabe engeri gye yayogerangamu ne Mukama,
and how God used to answer him,
ne Mukama engeri gye yayanukulangamu.
So verse 10 says,
ikumi egamba,
then the Lord spoke his word to him.
Kama nayogera ekigambo kye gyali.
God asked Elijah, why are you here?
Namubuuza lwaki oli wano Elijah.
He answered,
naddamu,
God all powerful.
Katondo wa amanyi.
This is Elijah answering God.
Kati Elijah yanukula Mukama.
God all powerful.
Katondo wa amanyi.
I have always served you as well as I could.
Kwereza mu bulungi nga bwe nsobodde.
But the people of Israel have broken their agreement with you.
Naye abantu ba Isirayiri bamenye endagaano yo.
They've broken your altars.
Ebyoto byo babimenye.
They've killed your prophets.
Basse banabbi
bo. With swords.
N'ebitala.
I am the only prophet left.
Era nze nabbi ekasigadde.
And now they are trying to kill me.
Ate nange bannemedde ko baagala kunsanyawo.
This is Elijah praying. This is a prayer, because prayer is communication between you and God, and God and you.
Okusaba obwo yogera ne Mukama nga ne Mukama ayogera naawe.
But now people think prayer is going down and you create a situation that is not there.
Ogenda wansi n'otondawo embeera etaliiyo. N'ofukamira.
I am the only prophet left there. They are trying to kill me.
Zeka sigaddeo ne nange baagala kunzita.
The Lord said to Elijah,
kama namunyanukula namugamba,
go and stand in front of me on the mountain.
Gendo imire maso gange ku lusozi.
I will pass by you.
Nja kuitako.
And so forth and so forth, and you'll go on to see how the wind came and the fire and etc. But the point here is that there is a level Elijah, the prophet, had reached where he used to talk to God and God would talk back to him. It wasn't a matter of kneeling down and crying and crying and saying, Lord, bless me with a house, a car, this and that. You know why? There is an assignment that God had given him.
Waliwo omulimu Katonda gwe yali amuwadde.
A kingdom assignment.
Omulimu nga gwa kabaka.
That is why largely you see today,
kyovola ba olabira ddala leero,
people are complaining that God is not hearing them.
Abantu beemulugunya nti Katonda tabawulira.
Because
kubanga
your prayers are supposed to be divine inspired, not man made.
Esala zo zino kubanga zilungamizibwa moyo nenga si tezikoleddwa muntu.
What do I mean?
Chiche ntegeza.
At a higher level spiritually,
kudale disingira dala mu moyo.
You all of you,
mwena.
Even those who are watching me, you have a purpose to fulfill on the kingdom of God. You have something to do in the kingdom of God. Now you find that these people who were supposed to fulfill their purpose are instead now fulfilling a purpose of the world. And it is one of the reasons why things are not working out in your life. You are far from what where God wants you. You see, when you read this verse, you'll see that the prophet told the Lord God that they are killing your prophet. Though they've killed them all, even me, they want to kill
me.
And that is the same position which also me, Prophet William, am in.
Kati embera yemu ne Prophet Jalimo, Prophet William.
You know, it is so difficult to be anointed.
Kizibu nnyo okubanga ofwafikibwa kamafuta.
Because everyone is critiquing you in their, you know, through their own lens.
Kubanga buli omu aba akukengeramu mu ngeri ye.
Last week, there are media houses that have started being used they're trying to use, but I know the people who are behind them, I know them, and their aim is to pull me down. They are there, I know them. And I know what is angering them is because of the anointing, that's number one. Number two, it's the power. Number three, it is because I have more than them. They can't hate someone who is not below, who is below them. But these people, I want to send a warning to you. The mountain you are trying to climb is not short. The God who is fighting for me will also fight for you in the name of Jesus Christ. The God that has brought me this far will also take you far in the name of
Jesus.
So, don't be afraid. Don't lose faith. When you see different media houses writing all sorts of negative things about
you.
If they were writing good things, that would have meant that I am maybe serving them.
But
I am serving the Almighty. I'm serving the Almighty.
Amen.
That's why you see, when I see someone trying to bring up a story against me, you've not brought it against the man, you've brought it against the spirit of the man. So if no one is against you, that means you are not doing enough. Let God bless you so that you get enemies. That's my prayer for you tonight. My prayer for you tonight. Let God raise you high.
Amen.
So that you get enemies.
Amen.
And those enemies look at you.
Amen.
They envy you. But they will never reach you. So there has to be an assignment over your life for you to make the covenant that you have to make with God. Because someone is there asking, yeah, he has talked about covenant. Now, how do I make a covenant? Jesus has no law firm. There is no law firm you're going to find. You're going to go on the second floor and you sign.
When
you have an agreement or a covenant with someone, there has to be evidence.
And
in this case, the evidence is the calling that you have. God has placed something in your life. But because you are not so close to Him, you cannot be able to avidly see it. Let me give you a short story. A few years ago, there's a friend of mine who called me. He said, you know what? Prophet, you've been doing so much. Come and take a rest in my home.
Prophet, you've
So this was someone that I had last talked to years ago. I said no. He said, because in my mind I say, this one now, whose house is he going to put me in? I said, no, I'll come, but I'll get a hotel, I'll stay outside.
And
sister said, no, my home is big. God blessed me through your prayers. I would like you to just come, I can give you your own.
Kati nali agado je.
I was skeptic, you know. I said, who is this person?
Kati ngamuli nebuza, ani muntu chono?
Who invites me to sleep in their home? Who are you?
Atuko kumpita mungende mu nyumba ye nebake yo. Nyumba chi.
So I said, let me try.
Ninga akangezeko.
I wanted to put him off in a polite way.
Kati nali njagala kugana mu ngeri ennyangu.
So I called him. I said, it's okay, I'll come. But I only fly business class. If you don't have business class, we shall see each other on WhatsApp video.
He said,
no, prophet, no problem. I was there, so William Ssozi, business class. I said,
ticket.
I said, okay. I got my bags. But I called him again. I said, ha. I only travel in Mercedes-Benz. I wanted to see how far will this go. He said, prophet, no problem. Those are small things. So I reached the airport. Someone came, picked me up. Took me, they say, Prophet William?
Prophet William.
So we drove up to the man's house. We drove. Now, when we reached the gate, I saw the man opening the gate. It looked like apartment. So I asked the driver, I said, are you taking me to apartments? No, the gentleman, this is his home. I couldn't believe my eyes. We entered from the gate to the home is 2 kilometers of just... So in my mind I say, I undermine this man. I wish I had asked for 3 cars behind me. So we drove. It wasn't until I was in denial the whole time.
Sikiriza.
I was in denial. Until I saw the young guy I prayed for years ago.
Nalaba omuvuka omuto gwe nasabira emyaka mingi emabega.
So I greeted his hand. I said, hello.
Nimbuza.
How much are you paying for rent here?
Rent wano sasula meka.
He said, no!
Da.
This is my home.
Ano nyumba yangi.
Have you ever prayed for someone?
Wali osabide ko omuntu.
And even you begin to, the blessings that you prayed for, they also shock you. That I say, on this side, there were horses. On the other side, there was a water fountain. The man said, these are your prayers, not mine. So I didn't want to show the man that I don't believe in my own prayers. I say, yeah, these are my prayers. God heard us.
Katonda
yatuulira. I say, yeah. So we enter the man's house. He showed me all there that you see is mine. I have a golf course here. I have one. I said, Prophet, come, I take you to your room. We walked. Remember, I had come from the airport. I was tired. We walked. I've never walked in a home. And my legs start paining. And he showed me what is there. So anyway, long story short, I asked him, my son, why did you build something like this? 17 bedrooms, 3 lifts and all this. And you know the country where he stays in, there are seasons. You know what he told me? He said, in January to March, I stay in this other side of the house. From March to July, I stay this side. From July to whatever, I stay this side. I said,
Kamba.
So it brought a challenge in my mind. Then I said, this guy, I knew him before he was all this that he is. You know what he told me? He said, when God blessed him, it changed the way he thinks. He said, Prophet, you see me here, but I no longer think like a poor man.
Prophet, undaba wanasichaloza ngomu sajo mwavu. Sicha inandoza ya bavu.
He said, I've been able to meet powerful people and they've been able to come here.
Nsobodo kusinka na wantu waba amani. Ila waba mba sobodo kutia wanu.
But it's not because the house is so, it's not because I'm so nice looking of a person. It is because of what I have. Because if I didn't have any of this, before I had any of this, no one knew me. Ladies and gentlemen, your blessing will speak for you in the name of Jesus. Your blessing will speak for you. You won't have to say so much. You won't. They'll see you from far and say, that woman is blessed. That man is blessed. It is what we call assignment from God. You cannot make a covenant with God If you do not have evidence, and that evidence is a calling, raise up your right hand and say in the name of Jesus, bring me closer to my assignment. Bring me closer to your words. In the name of Jesus, I want to see you in my life. I want to see you working for me. And I want to see your power reigning over my life. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let's put our hands together for Jesus. Whatever you do, it will no longer be in your own strength. It will be backed up by the Holy Father. And if there is anyone who is fighting you, the power of God will speak for you in the name of Jesus. So I'm going to be here briefly. If you have a special seat, you will be able to meet me. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I want to say this. Within the coming few days from now, I saw a disease. And it is coming from two places. From Tanzania.
Tanzania.
The lower part of Tanzania.
Tanzania.
And the other side.
No ruda ruli.
May come from Congo.
Congo.
There is a sickness that may attack East Africa or Africa at large.
Africa or East Africa.
Within the few coming weeks.
Weeks is it?
The good news you have is that God has already covered you with His precious hand. The power of God will be with you. Let's close our eyes. Father, as they depart, I ask you to be with them, to touch them, to bless them. For your hand to be upon them at all times. Whatever happens, it happens under the instructions of you. Father, they will not be alone again. Whatever happens will happen under your instructions. I ask you, Holy Father, to touch them, to bless them, preserve them, keep them until next week, when we meet again. Father, bless them, touch the mighty name of God. Grant power of God. Whatever you do will be blessed. God bless you and see you next week.